There's a lot going on here, and some of it we have not discussed before. As an example, the exclamation marks indicate these are implicitly unwrapped optionals, a concept in Swift that you'll learn in the UI Kit Fundamentals lesson in the later part of the course. Let's break down the audio recorder code piece by piece. You can see we first import AVFoundation, the framework that has AVAudioRecorder. Without this import, Xcode won't know about any AVFoundation classes, and our iOS app won't compile. If we scroll down to the record audio function, here we see what looks like the code to get the directory path and build a full path, including the file name. In essence, this grabs the pitch perfect document directory and stores it as a string in the dir path constant. Later in this course, when we get to persistence, you'll learn the various directories and storage locations available in iOS. For now, we just need a place to store the audio recording, and the documents directory will work just fine. A few lines down, we make an array with a directory path and the file name. Join those together and create a URL to use with AVAudioRecorder. We also print out the path, so you can see it in the console. Next up, we grab the AVAudioSession and set up the category to play and record. In order to either record or playback audio, we need an audio session. There's just one that exists for the entire time your app is running, and we grab it with the SharedInstance method. The AVAudioSession class is basically an abstraction over the audio hardware. Since there's only one audio hardware, there's only one instance of AVAudioSession. You grab the SharedInstance that's used by all apps on the iOS device. This is a common pattern you will find in Cocoa Touch. When you reach into the iOS API and grab a singleton, it is usually a function called SharedInstance. So with the AVAudioSession set up, we can set up the AVAudioRecorder. Here, we see the line with AVAudioRecorder inside of a try statement without handling if it fails. We will cover error handling later in this course. For now, we can just assume it will work. We tell it to prepare recording and start recording. That's it. AVAudioRecorder is now recording audio.